What is up, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy Guy Pandemonium, bringing you a playthrough video here, part one for Madness Beverage. Now, I have already started this game, and a couple things I want to go ahead and note out for you that'll help you guys out a lot more than it helped me. First quick tip is one, once you start a mission after the first one, there is no escaping out of it. You are essentially stuck in that mission until you beat it, and there is no way to lower the difficulty that you have chosen while in game as well. So if you get stuck or hung up on a part like I did, you're basically stuck there until you're able to finally beat it, which is no bueno. So I'm gonna go part by part on which ones I believe are the best ones to go through and why, in my opinion, they're the best to go through them exactly in that order. So I'm gonna go ahead and start off with a brand new game here though. Won't be talking but so much. I will not talk through the cutscenes. I'll let you guys hear it out. Premise of the game is that you are essentially a mercenary on a bounty hunt for a villain called Manos, and you're kind of hunting demons. Very Doom-like game, probably caters toward a younger age group for Doom. However, there is still vulgar language, so if you're not allowed to listen to vulgar language, go ahead and you may want to skip this series. I'll get with another series here shortly, but we're gonna go ahead and dive right on to Madness Beverage, the new game. We're going to go ahead and put it down on hard, that way I don't have to necessarily do two playthroughs of the game itself. So we're going to keep it here on normal. We're going to get started.
Boss, there is a galaxy-wide broadcast incoming.
Oh, put it on speaker, babe. What the fuck? Demons? The hell? That's definitely not good for business. That asshole has to go down. I bet there'll be a bounty on him soon. We need to get there before any other mercenaries. Babe, give me the coordinates to that signal.
Data transfer scan. Initiated. Accessing message properties. Neil Valkyrie prefix. Identified.
So, he's in the old castle? That place creeps me out. Anyway, set the course for Neo Valkyria Castle.
So after that cutscene, what you're going to want to go ahead and do is look over here to your right. There's a control panel here. You want to kind of look in this general direction to press X. Only for that one, for some reason, these guys don't do anything over here. So we're going to go ahead and come on over here. We're going to start up Neo Valkyria. As you can tell, it kind of gives you a brief description on what exactly is going on, kind of like a little bit to the story. Up to you guys if you want to read it. I've read actually quite a few of them. Storyline isn't necessarily that great, so I wouldn't worry too much with it. Like I said, the whole premise is you're a mercenary, here's a target or a bounty that you are now going after. Alright, so, gonna go ahead and pull up the input here for the buttons. Very similar to any first-person shooter, right trigger shoot, left trigger aim. The only difference, left bumper, that actually changes your weapon, while the right bumper is grenade. Y and X are actually for, I guess, reloading until you actually get the power drinks. Holding B crouches, A jumps, and obviously right, left's analog stick to do what you need. Now, I will say another thing here is that when you are sprinting, one thing to notice when you're walking and jumping, not very much. When you're sprinting and jumping, you can do a whole lot. You can even jump back quite a good ways. See if I can get it here. For some reason, it doesn't want to work out this time. But you can jump around quite a bit. That'll actually throw you off in some later parts. Left trigger aims in. As you can tell, the actual sight does not line up with the gun, which is a little infuriating. However, it doesn't matter too much once you see what this thing shoots. holding B. Like I said, it's crouches. You can't tap it. You have to hold it. So we're going to get started. And for those who are wondering, I will do a collectible walkthrough if you so choose. I kind of messed that first part up, but regardless. One thing that I would like for you to note is that you can actually outrun these smaller guys quite easily, actually, by just simply walking backwards. You don't actually have to sprint backwards. You can just actually walk backwards and be perfectly fine.
Bring it on, ugly piece of shit.
Trying to use some grenades here to kind of save on the ammo. As one thing I would like to tell you is that you will not die on hard difficulty to the enemies themselves without it being because of one reason, you running out of ammo. And one thing I have noticed that I will go ahead and throw in is that I have noticed that your ammo carries over into the next mission. So if you have no ammo at the end of a mission, you're not going to have any ammo at the beginning of the next. So it might be worth it instead of going to the final spot just to kind of look around, see if you can grab ammo anywhere else. Another thing that I want to note is the grenades are actually pretty powerful and they do help you a ton, and it is something you will have to learn how to use relatively quickly for a certain level. And I'll get into that one later on when the time comes.
Rest in pieces, bitch.
Another thing I will note to this game is that the spawns are not the best. Things will spawn right on top of you, which I understand it's supposed to be a fast-paced first-person shooter, so I have no issues with that for the most part. However, there are certain monsters that you will fight on certain levels that can become a legit pain and nuisance and can actually basically cause you to die even when you're at full health pretty quickly if you're not paying attention. But as I stated, we'll get into that later. So once you walk into this first room, you're going to want to get to the left. All the way. You're basically going to hug the left wall here. And this is what I mean by you can essentially walk backwards faster than the actual enemies themselves. So once you're through there, should be, where are you at? One wall over. This is where the Doom concept of the buttons and triggers actually come into play. It's actually a pretty nice concept that I'm actually glad that they kind of took from Doom to make you kind of explore the map a little bit more. They're gonna hug the far right wall basically the whole way to the end. Far. And there's our door.
Please.
Now I do encourage you to actually go exploring in this game. Exploring will help you out a ton, not only with ammo wise, but also you have the collectibles as well that you need to find. Now that door is locked, however, you can just simply come up here and you can shoot the button. Shoot it a couple times, you'll get the notification something just happened, and the door will now be open. And a lot of these doors will say they're locked, and if you sit there long enough, it'll say find the button. Now this is also being played on Xbox Series X, if anyone is wondering, just for graphic reasons. And I will go ahead and tell you if you want to change the actual sound. volume you can, as it is the same sound throughout the entire game. It does not change, or not that I have noticed from previous plays. Now essentially what we have here is a chest. This is kind of what contains all the guns that you'll get between your weapons, heavy weapons, and drinks. We only have the starting weapon, so we don't have to worry about that too much at the current time. There. As you can tell, even on hard you don't take but so much damage. Now this next door, I absolutely have no idea what causes it to trigger to open. Generally I just kind of stay in that room I was just in a moment ago. I just kind of keep shooting and killing everything that spawns and comes in here. It just kind of kills everything in this area until I hear the door click. Which there are audio cues to let you know that the door has officially been opened. Another thing that is kind of a pain to have to deal with is determining when you've actually killed something. It's not really a very good indicator on when that's happened, so you just kind of have to go with it. The bigger guys here, you can just strafe side to side relatively easily, killing them. And as you saw earlier, enough of it will cause you to will take some damage pretty quickly. Now I didn't hear an audio cue, so it's always nice every now and then just to check in on that door. Yeah, here. Definitely a game where you will want to check corners. Now this is where things will get a little hectic, a little busy, the door closes behind you. So try and focus on one side at a time. Now there are quite a few health packs in the game in this area to begin, so go ahead and run on up there and grab your health if you're getting a little low like I was. And then here's kind of a, you can shoot down the alley. At a certain distance, these guys won't shoot at you, so it's always a plus. So you kind of use that to your advantage in that area. As I stated earlier, your ammo does transfer in between. You don't always start off with full ammo, so make sure you always have full ammo going into each fight as much as you can. Here's gonna be a little bit hectic, but not too terrible. I can show you real quickly how to go about it. You're gonna want to run over here. You essentially have to wait for this door to unlock, which is a bit of a pain, to say the least. So just kind of sitting here watching that door, waiting for it to pop open. So they don't really do too good of a job on explaining what to do and where to go about things, so you kind of have to figure out as you go, which I kind of enjoy the challenge of trying to figure things out like that, but some people do not. Now here's a very quick way to go about it, so you can skip actually a good bit. Just come in, shoot that, something just happened, opens this door that was to the right that was locked. You can then run in really quickly here. You can just spray that back wall, hopefully the guy's not in the way. Get another notification for something just happened. And you can sprint off to the side hall here. The door will be open, so you can go ahead and go in here. and you can start up the final fight area, which is not too terribly difficult because of what I said previously. You actually walk faster than these guys, so you just kind of walk backwards, spraying them down. Every now and then you'll want to turn around, look where you're going, make sure you're not getting ready to bump into anybody, anything. So right there, that hand, essentially what that does is it stuns you and will lock you in place. For the very first level here, it's not too terrible. It'll just hit you and stun you momentarily. However, on other levels, it has abilities such as, for instance, the ice level. It's called the Old Russian Ice Line, Ice Spike, something like that. I can't remember the name. Old Russian Winterland. It is a pain because it blends in perfectly well with the background, and it will actually freeze you in place for probably 3 to 4 seconds, which is more than enough time for them to do anything. Now, as you can see, I could simply rush in here and finish the game. However, that's not what I want to do, as I know I have low ammo, and ammo is what gets carried over throughout all the other missions. So you're going to spend a few seconds running around grabbing any extra ammo that you see laying around. Because the more the better, and as I said, you'll be finding yourself dying, not because of the enemies themselves, but just because you don't have any ammo at all. Health is the same exact way, so anytime you can just run around, scavenge what little bits out there, it's always better to go in with a little more than none at all. And this, from what I can understand, is the main villain. So, just go ahead and lay into him. As you can see, he takes a ton of damage. He's just a legit tank that is, above all, a pain to have to deal with. He's just a giant bullet sponge. As I said, with that sprint jump, it actually can come in handy. It allows you to clear a pretty good gap relatively quickly by just simply pressing in and holding the left stick and then hitting the jump button. But every now and then you will in fact bounce into him, which isn't necessarily what you want to have happen, but it happens. You want to go ahead and grab any ammo you can, and we'll go back to shooting him. He is very annoying, so just have to keep shooting him, laying into him. You will more than likely run out of ammo and have to resort to slapping him. Don't understand why they decided to make him such a bullet sponge, but they did. simple. Once you see him flash to you, just immediately turn to look at him and back up. As I told you earlier, you'll probably be running out of ammo a lot in this game, and here is a prime example of it. Out of ammo, trying to find some. Nothing but health packs, so it's gonna come into, let's smack him on around a little bit. Just slap, 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 slap. Slap, 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 clap, clap, clap. And once your health gets low, just make a play for one of the actual health kits, which there should be quite a few. See, I let that get a little lower than I wanted it to, but... go ahead and start scavenging for more health kits. Trigger another cutscene.
Is that all you got, Captain Big Mouth? I didn't even break a sweat.
The fuck just happened? Damn, he's so fast and powerful.
Damn straight, Big Mouth. Thanks to my newly acquired powers, I was able to close the gate and become the most powerful being in the universe.
Powers? That's cheating. I will... Give me a ride to Canatan. If anyone knows how this moron got so strong, it will be Zeos. Next time, I will rip his head off. You mean person.
Roger that. Same course. To Canatan.
So that is the end of the first level, and I'll go ahead and take you to the next step. What you're going to want to do is go to this way. Just kind of a brief little dialogue scene at the space market. Nothing crazy, no fighting. So off the start, you're gonna want to go over here. Now one thing you can do while going ahead is coming over here. Get a refill on grenades. As far as I know, from where I've been, you can only get grenade refills so far. I don't know what point you're allowed to get ammo refills, if you can. But for the most part, it's just grenades. Then here's your guy you're going to want to talk to.
Hey there, Zeos.
You? The fuck you doing here? I haven't seen you in years, Caleb.
Yeah, listen, Zeos. I got a favor to ask. Heard about that Manus demon crap? Well, I went there to grab him for a potential bounty, but instead I got my ass kicked, and I need to know why. He said something about madness power.
The info spreads around here very fast, mate. We already know that that bully there got his powers from madness drops that he turned into powerful drinks. He is very dangerous with those.
Sounds like some infinity power drink crap. Okay, man, where can I find some?
It's your lucky day, kid. I will prepare a map of all drops locations. There is plenty of that stuff in my galaxy. Just remember to pick only one at a time. Getting more drops from the place might burn you to ash. That's how powerful they are.
Okay, understood. Still, I need to know how to use them.
My boys will prepare a beverage out of the drops' power. No worries. But, as a fair trade, I will keep some of the beverage for myself.
No problem. Sounds fair. You never let me down.
Good thing is we have one
And then after that conversation, that kind of cues up why it's called Madness Beverage. The actual chemical itself is madness, and they were able to turn it into a beverage. What a crafty title. So here it goes. Purple drink tells you what it all does. All damage reduced by 25%, which will become very handy for certain levels. Deals damage pushed out nearby enemies upon drink's power, and you attract monsters by loud actions. And then the good old shotgun, this thing is actually a tank at close range. They don't give it its credit it needs. Very low accuracy, I find, is an understatement, unless if you're trying to snipe with it, which why would you try and snipe with a shotgun? But then again, you never know, you might want to try and get a clip on some NPCs, I don't know. So, and then LV here does swap your weapons, as you can see I have no ammo in that, and then I have the shotgun here. So we are going to go on and head on back to the ship to get ready to queue up the next mission, which will start up part 2 of this series. So hopefully guys, you guys enjoyed the first part of this game so far. It is a unique little first person shooter, especially for being the price of $18.99. Hopefully there's a long story to it. It looks like there's quite a few missions. So you're going to come back over here to your table. So there's at least, I know, 5 missions, and judging the achievement list, there's something going to be happening at Space Mark, so it's at least 6 more missions, plus I believe there to be a final boss mission. So from right now, we're going to go ahead and call it quits here. This will be where we stop the game, stop part 1, and we'll actually go by part 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, whatever it is, and it'll be titled with the mission that's related to it. So for those of you guys that are wanting to go, you know, what's the best route, you go ahead and just stay tuned. You'll be able to look at the parts on which way I go. I recommend Old Russian Renterlands. I recommend that one to be probably one of the last missions you do, as you will run out of ammo in the same spot every time. And to me, there's just, I can't figure out a way, or I could not figure out a way for a few hours on how to go past that point. So the next mission will be Passage to the New Underworld. From there, we will then go to Lava Caves, to Secret Laboratory or Alien Planet, then vice versa, and back to Old Russian Winterlands. So, till next time, guys. Hope you all have a great time. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed the video. Please feel free to like, comment, subscribe. Peace.